got me eye on you.
Best blade's not worth shite if a weak arm's swinging it, ain't.
Looking pretty.
Swords need thumping.
Greetings, White Wolf. I suspected you'd come by. Bah! I was sure of it.
Oh, yeah?
The best stocked armory in all Skellig is right here at Kaer Trolde Castle. Everyone knows it.
I'll gladly see for myself.
Take your time. Give them all a careful look.
Looking for someone who can make me a master quality breastplate.
Never known a master who wasn't a dwarf.
Fergus, perhaps? Say he's holed up somewhere in Velen.
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. So long.
What's this?
It's, a doormat.
I wonder if he's a stranger. Interested in the weapon? There's a tail behind every item I've got.
What are you peddling? This sword's hilt is made of meteorite steel.
No. It's made from the heart of a fallen star. Whoever wields this sword will always find his way at sea, no matter how stormy the skies. But after a time, it overwhelms its owner with sadness and longing for its starry home. And nothing, not even good fun and good company, can cheer him up.
So long.
got me eye on you. Friends, we show heart. Foes, we show our backs.
Drink last night, too?
Adventure seeker. Keld hung there half a day before they got him down.
I've always said only a fool would hang himself in midair in a wooden box.
But sailing the sea in a wooden box, that's wise.
You fall off a ship, you can always swim. Fall off the lift, all that's left is the funeral.
Last night was...
Hey,
what's that supposed to mean?
Have mercy. Who'll I leave my home to if Chalva dies? Who'll continue my line?
Mind if I interrupt?
Nay. My prayers are in vain anyways.
Hear you're having trouble with a curse.
I am. Look. See it lying there? The horse head on the pole? That's...
A Nithing. Kind of curse, seen this before. They're nothing to scoff at, can bring misfortune, even death.
Aye, and the name carved upon it is Tialva, my firstborn. The boy's feverish, grows weaker by the day. I fear I'll bury him before the next moon. Tried to lift the curse myself, but no luck.
I can help you one of two ways. First, I can try to convince whoever put up the Nithing to lift the curse themselves. Second, I can deflect the curse back on whoever cast it by writing their name on the shaft. Either way, need to know who's behind this.
But I don't trouble no one. Don't know a soul who'd wish it upon me.
Mm-hmm. Guess I gotta investigate. Might want to look around some. A Nithing. A powerful curse. Name carved on the shaft. Tjalve, son of Lothar. Shawl. Distinctive pattern. Distinctive smell. Too many scents. Can't follow my nose any further. Need to ask around about the shawl.
If you hear something in the woods, like the rattle of a deer, or be loud.
You, Odin?
I am. Hear about me, sonny?
Let's talk about my reward first.
It's a lot. I'll need to borrow from kin, but you have it. Won't spare no coin for me, boy.
Where should I look for your son?
East of here. Midst the ruins of the fortress. He went there with some rogues from Pharaoh. Met him at the tavern. They filled his head with nonsense about some treasure. I said, Sonny, Pharaoh folk are liars to a man. You shouldn't fraternize with them. But he knew better.
How'll I recognize him? All I know is he doesn't listen to his father. Pretty typical for his age.
His name's Olve. A cheerful lad. A bit of a lisp. Nothing special about his looks. Except last I saw him, he was wearing a yellow tunic. Lovely. None other like it in the village. Got it from me a year back, on his birthday.
That ought to do it. I'll look around. No promises, though.